out in the Alps here. Absolutely beautiful. It's only a handful of degrees, and out in the bush, it's looking quite a bit to get out here. Probably about half an hour via ATV quad. And I just want to show this quick setup. Might be useful to some owners out there of the tank, Elstar tank, and show you a bit of a setup that I've got. I've made a neat little rack just out of aluminium. Used a pipe bender and welded a couple of tacks on there for a couple of utilities. Got an axe, normally got a chainsaw on there as well. But more importantly, these bikes are great. Once you run them in, and they're just very reliable. I can't justify buying a name brand bike. This, I mean, literally, I think it was, $1,200 or I don't know, $1,300 thereabouts. It wasn't very much, and rides well. But what I did find was a little noisy, especially if you're out working overnight. And what I did is a little modification. Might be useful. And the guy that imports these, Eric, suggested, and thank you, Eric, for the tip, that you should put a weld on a little washer and drill a hole in the back of the exhaust, because they do get, they sound like a Harley Davidson, and out on the property it's not what you need. So I'm going to show you that in a minute. Got the 477 meg and HF as well, 27 meg. And got those nicely mounted up there. Working away, got 27 meg here as well. Not much happening probably. Now it's quiet. But let's start her up and let's see how quiet she is. And you know, I can talk, and you know, it's not too too noisy. And here's my little modification right there. All I've done is I've used a passion fruit tin, cut the lid off it, and used a 60 mil pipe clamp and drilled a 10 mil hole on the back of it. And that's it. And really nice and quiet. Let's give it a rev. Beautiful, really quiet. Let's take it off. You can straight away see the difference. Give it a rev. So you can see the difference. So that's basically all I did. Just used a little passion fruit can with a pipe clamp. That nicely slips on. I'll probably make a little bit of aluminium and make it all proper, but I thought just to shut it up now, I'd do that. And that reduces it from a hole that big down to that. So I hope that's useful. And if you're a cocky or anything like that and you're thinking of buying one of these, I think you'll do okay. You'll probably have enough money left in the bank to go for a little holiday somewhere, or buy some feed for your stock. That's for sure. All right. Well, I've hope you enjoy this really short video, quick video, unrelated to my other videos. I'll do some more technical things soon. Just been caught up with academic wranglings and so forth. So I'll do some more. Interesting video soon. Anyway, here's a couple of little tack-ons of just me running about the paddock. Ooh, it gives you an idea how cold it is. Bit icy. It's cold. We'll go through this rough stuff here. Easy. No problems at all for the tank.